the Writer's Almanac for Sunday, October the 18th, 2020. It's the birthday of A.J. Liebling, Abbot Joseph Liebling, New York City, 1904, staff writer for the New Yorker magazine for many years, whose co-workers at the magazine said they often heard him laughing in his office over his own stuff, who was known to stay up all night at the office pounding away at the typewriter, and in the morning he would give himself a bath in the sink in the men's room. A.J. Liebling, who wrote about food, about journalism, about boxing, author of the book Between Meals and Appetite for Paris, and who covered World War II, writing about day-to-day life among the soldiers. He later wrote about the war years. The times were full of certainties. We could be certain we were right, and we were. And that certainty made us certain that anything we did was right, too. I have seldom been sure I was right since. I know that it is socially acceptable to write about war as an unmitigated horror. But subjectively, at least, it was not true. And you can feel its pull on men's memories at the maudlin reunions of war divisions. They mourn for their dead, but also for war. A.J. Liebling, who said, "Cynicism is often the shame-faced product of inexperience." It's the birthday of Terry McMillan, born Port Huron, Michigan, 1951, author of the novel Waiting to Exhale, one of the first novels to portray middle-class African-Americans who don't have to struggle against racism or poverty. Terry McMillan, who said, "I don't write about victims. They just bore me to death. I prefer to write about somebody who can pick themselves back up and get on with their lives." It's the birthday of the playwright Wendy Wasserstein, born Brooklyn, 1950, devoted herself to theater instead of family life. So she wrote a play about it, The Heidi Chronicles, 1988, about a woman who's clung to all her feminist ideals while all of her friends have given them up and gone on to have children. Wendy Wasserstein, who said, "The marriages come and go, but your friendships stay, which is the opposite of what it used to be, so that there will be people in our lives for 30 years, and often it is not your husband, it's your women friends, male friends, with whom you come of age." It's the birthday of the novelist Rick Moody, New York City, 1961, grew up in the Connecticut suburbs, whose passion for writing was ignited by reading Hemingway's The Old Man and the Sea in the sixth grade. He said, "I probably liked the Hemingway novel because I was very interested in sharks." His first novel was Garden State, came out in 1992, of which the author said, "I think it's a truly dreadful book, but it's emotionally accessible and vulnerable, and I admire that." Here's a poem for today by W.S. Merwin, entitled The New Song. "For some time I thought there was time, and that there would always be time for what I had a mind to do, and what I could imagine going back to and finding it as I had found it the first time. But by this time, I do not know what I thought when I thought back then. There is no time, yet it grows less. There is the sound of rain at night, arriving unknown in the leaves, once without before or after. Then I hear the thrush waking at daybreak, singing the new song." The New Song, a poem by W.S. Merwin from The Moon Before Morning, published by Copper Canyon Press and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac. Funded by donations from listeners like you, now available on PRX for distribution by your local radio station. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.